Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you? Hopefully, all of you would be in very good condition of health, happiness, and faith. Wish you all the best. In the previous lecture, we learned about the introduction, the importance, and the method of Hajj. And today, we will learn about Umrah, the method of Umrah, and the difference between Hajj and Umrah. If someone of you has not learned about the introduction, importance, and method of Hajj, he or she should visit my YouTube channel, O Level Islamiyat Lectures, and listen to the lecture with the title Hajj Part 1. Hajj Part 1. And inshallah, everything would be clear to you after listening to that lecture. Today, we will discuss about Umrah, the method of Umrah, and what are the differences between Hajj and Umrah. Umrah, you may write with O-M-R-A-H or U-M-R-A-H. Both spellings would be considered as right. Umrah, sometimes written as U-M-R-A-H, is known as minor pilgrimage. Umrah is known as minor pilgrimage. Allah has mentioned Umrah twice in the Holy Quran. Umrah, like Hajj, begins with putting on ihram at Miqat. Pilgrims recite Talbiyah, reach Kaaba, offer tawaf of the Holy Kaaba, offer two rakat of nafl at station of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and perform sa'i. After it, the men get their heads shaved and women cut locks of their hair. I should revise. Umrah, which is known as minor pilgrimage, is mentioned twice in the Holy Quran. Like Hajj, Umrah begins with putting on ihram at Miqat. Pilgrims recite Talbiyah, reach Makkah, offer tawaf of the Holy Kaaba, offer two rakat of nafl at the station of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and perform sa'i. After this, the men get their heads shaved and the women cut locks of their hair. What is the difference between Hajj and Umrah? Dear students, although some acts of worship performed in Umrah are the same as those performed in Hajj, yet there are some fundamental differences between the two. What are those differences? Number one, Hajj is obligatory while Umrah is not. Obligatory means farz. In Arabic, it is known as farz, and Urdu as well. Hajj is obligatory, means Hajj is farz, while Umrah is not. Umrah is not farz, it's not obligatory. Number two, Hajj can only be performed in the prescribed month and dates. You know, in the month of Zulhajj, and the prescribed dates. Whereas Umrah can be performed at any time, other than the time of Hajj. Other than the time of Hajj. Wakuf-e-Arafah is one of the key components of a Hajj. You know, students, pilgrims, while offering Hajj, must stay at Arafat on 9th of Zulhajj. That is indispensable part of Hajj, to stay at Arafat on 9th of Zulhajj. But in Umrah, pilgrims need not to stay at Arafah. It means there is no waqoof at Arafah in Umrah. Similarly, there is no waqoof at Muzdalifah in Umrah. Waqoof at Muzdalifah. Staying at Muzdalifah is not the part of Umrah. The talbiyah is stopped on arrival at the Masjid al-Haram in Umrah. If you are performing Umrah, you have to stop talbiyah as soon as you reach Masjid al-Haram. Whereas in Hajj, the talbiyah continues till the first rami on the 10th of Zulhajj. Pilgrims stay at Mina, perform rami, and offer sacrifice in Hajj. Stay at Mina, perform rami, and offer sacrifice in Hajj. But none of these acts is performed in Umrah. But none of these acts is performed in Umrah. So these were the differences between Hajj and Umrah. I should revise these differences again. Hajj is obligatory while Umrah is not. Hajj can only be performed in the prescribed month and dates, whereas Umrah can be performed at any time other than the time of Hajj. Waqoof Arafah is one of the key components of Hajj, whereas there is no Waqoof Arafah in Umrah. Similarly, there is no Waqoof Muzdalifah in Umrah. The talbiyah is stopped on arrival at Masjid al-Haram in Umrah. Whereas in Hajj, the talbiyah continues till the first rami on the 10th of Zulhajj. Pilgrims stay at Mina, perform rami, and offer sacrifice in Hajj, but none of these acts is performed in Umrah. So, students, this was the method of Umrah and the difference between Hajj and Umrah. I hope it would be, inshallah, a useful lecture for you all, because we discussed all these things in a very brief manner so that you may understand it easily. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.